Hi there, it's Robin here. Now the other day I was showing you about these two beautiful Berninas, but I just wanted to tell you a couple more things about the Bernina 740. So I did tell you to make sure you get your machines out of the cupboard and run them. Now if you start, when you plug your machine in, it plugs in at the side here, the power goes to the bottom and to the power plug, and you've got your foot control. Now, the foot controls are all different for the various machines, but this one, to make it sew, obviously, you're just going to push it down and it's going to start sewing. Now, if you do that and you take your foot off the pedal and at any stage your machine sews by itself, do not panic. Unplug your machine from the power socket and leave it. Take it to your sewing technician. Inside your foot control there is a capacitor, and inside your motor there is a capacitor. Now you also might experience a bit of smoke coming out of it. Don't panic, turn your machine off, because the technicians can remedy these. We've had people say, oh, my machine started smoking and I threw it out. Please don't throw it out. Take it to your technician and get them to check it for you, because quite often they can fix your machines. And that is another reason why it's important to get your machine serviced. So that's the foot control for my 740. The other thing I wanted to show you, when I showed you how to oil it, you can also clean your machine at the same time. Now here, I've got my foot down. I'm going to lift my foot up. There's a little lever at the back. I'm going to lift it up and take my foot off. I'm going to turn the machine around to show you that shortly. Now you can buy these cleaning brushes with a little hole on one end, and these are extremely helpful, and they'll be at any sewing store, because on this end with the hole you simply put this underneath your needle and you can hold your needle to unscrew your needle to change. So the screwdriver for these old machines look like this. If you go to a store and buy a new one, it might look a little bit different, but it will be, oh yeah, here it is. If you go to buy a new one, it will be the same end, so you can still buy it, but will look like this. So we don't get them now like this one. They have this end here, and this end is actually to take out a little light bulb. So there's the screwdriver that you will probably have. So it unscrews the screw and you can just pull your needle down like that to take it out. This one's a bit dusty. Now you've got a flat piece of your needle and a round front of your needle. So all of these machines, you just put it in this little holder here, hold your finger the flat to the back, and you can just push your needle back up into the groove, and you'll feel it because there's a gap where it goes. Make sure that's unscrewed. Push it up as far as it can go, and it's another reason why this is better than your finger, and then tighten it with the screw. Get it in the right place and tighten it. Now don't over tighten that screw either, and then just slide this down out of your needle and take it out, okay? Now to clean out under here, remember I showed you how to open this up. Now to clean down under here, you're just going to get your little screwdriver, and it fits in these screw holes. They're designed for the same screwdriver. So it's a great little screwdriver. So don't panic if you don't have it. You'll be able to pick one up at your local Bernina store. Oh, don't lose the screw. Take this out. You can actually leave your needle out and change your needle, because remember the life of a needle is 8 hours. Now this machine's nice and dirty to show you. So you can get your little brush now. Do not blow into your machine. Simply just brush out these little pieces here. Take out all the bits you can. And that will do a really good job. But Bernina have brought out these gorgeous brushes. They look like a makeup brush. And they are wonderful because they're lovely and soft and big. And I find them even better than these little tiny ones. But anyway, so they're one of the latest things Bernina have brought out, these beautiful little brushes. Don't put your makeup on with it either. They're just for the machine. Then you can put your plate back on. Now, if you have a look here, when I put the plate on, you can see here, I have got the feed dogs up. So when I run my finger along here, the feed dogs are up, and I have moved this little lever here, and that dropped my feed dogs down. So they're now hidden behind here. When I take this off, I can put my feed dogs up. Did you see them jump up? I'll show you that again. Down and up. So when the feed dogs are up, that's for machine sewing. When they're down, you can do darning or freehand embroidery. So when you're cleaning it, make sure you pop them up so you can make sure you get all the dust from inside there. And then you can put this back on, drop them down, put them back on, screw your screws up, and there you have your cleaning done. And I had shown you oiling in the last video. This screwdriver fits in here with that shape, goes down into the screw, and you tighten it up. And then there's one at the back. Put one at the back and tighten it up. Now I'm going to turn the machine around because I want to show you how I cut the thread, because it was very hard for you to see, and how you put the foot on correctly. So that's your needle and your threading. I'm going to close this. I'm going to put this up. I'm going to turn my light on. I'm going to unplug my machine. I'm going to turn my machine around. They're extremely heavy, so don't ruin your back. Just spin it around very gently. And here I'm going to show you how you put your foot on. So here's my foot. There's a little cone shape, and you go underneath that cone shape. You push your foot up as far as it will go, and there's a tiny little lever here, and you push your lever down. Now, if I turn it sideways, you can see that lever is holding my foot on. If I push it down, I'll push it up, it will undo it. Goodness me. So there's my cone shape. I'm sliding my foot up, my foot is straight, and I'm pushing that lever down. Now remember I told you that you can cut your thread? On the back of this lever that I've used, when I come round to cut my thread, I just go, I'll try and do it without getting my hands in the road, I'll come around this way. I just come across here, and you can feel there's a little nick in that little lever, and you just put your thread on there and the thread cuts. So there's a little cutter on the side. I'll show you again. Come round here, bring it round, and it cuts. So that's the cutter I was telling you about last time. So I just thought I should show you that. And the other thing you wouldn't have been able to see was where this thread comes around here. When you're threading, make sure you don't just go from here to there. It needs to come around that little lever there. Okay, that little one there. So it goes around and then up and over. Okay, so that's what I wanted to show you on there. It is exactly the same on this machine here. So I don't need to show you that. But I did tell you that I'm going to start teaching you how to use the feet. Now the feet that I'm going to show you, you can use on all the mechanical Bernina sewing machines. And all of the other ones as well, but we're doing mechanical machines today. So whether you've got a 1008, an 801, an 810, an 830, a 930, a 910, all of the numbers in between, you can use these feet. So this is my normal sewing foot. I'm going to lift the lever up at the back and I'm going to take it out. So the two feet I'm going to show you today are the Blindhemming foot, and it's number 016 or number 5, depending on the age of your machine. And this one is number 179 or number 16. So it all depends on the age of your machine. And you know these are 50 to 60 years old. So the first one I'm going to show you is the Blindhemming foot. Now the Blindhemming stitch on this machine is number 5. So remember, I'm going to put my lever to 1 to 20. And I'm going to bring this all the way up to number 5. I'm going to put my zigzag on 4. I'm going to put my needle position on right, and I'm going to put my stitch length about 2.5. Now, your book will tell you all the settings, but I'll do it again. Blind hemming is foot number 016 or number 5. On this machine, it is number 5 stitch, blind hem stitch. My lever goes from there to 1 to 20. My zigzag goes to 4. My needle position goes to the right. And my stitch length goes to down to 2.5. This goes on like I showed you, my little cone. And this has got a lever going through the middle here, a guide. So I'm going to put my thread down beside that guide, and then it's sitting here ready to go. Now, this is all on how you actually fold your fabric as to how it works. So say this is the hem of my garment here. I'm going to turn up my garment. So let's just pretend I'm turning up my garment. So there's my hem, okay? This is a raw edge. This is a knit fabric. I don't need to clean finish my knit fabric. It's not going to fray. And normally you're doing it on a fabric that's not going to fray. But if you did have a fabric that frayed, you could overlock this seam first with a single overlock. So I've turned up my hem. Actually, I'll put this back and show you. I've turned up my hem here. Now I'm going to pick this up and I'm going to fold it back and turn it over. So I'm going to show you again. Let me just put a couple of pins in there to show you. So you can pin your hem up if you like. A couple of pins, measure your hem. You can see my perfect measuring. Right, so there's my hem turned up, and then I'm simply going to fold it over. Okay, hem up, fold it over. You put your garment to the left. And I only want to have about half an inch. Now all you do is you run this guide here down your folded edge. So remember, this is your garment. Lay it all down. You're not going to sew on your pins because you're nowhere near your pins. Sit it down, and if you're worried, you can check that the heads of the pins are facing the correct way and that you're not going to sew over any of your pins. So if you want to at this stage, you could actually do this because they don't stretch. I'm only doing a little sample. You can go this way and then you don't have to worry about it at all. And you know what? Sometimes I tack that piece so I don't have to have any pins at all. So here's my garment, wrong side facing up, right side facing down. Now, with this stitch, what happens is it takes a bite out of the fabric here, okay? So I can see if I do that, I'm taking too much of a bite. So I'm going over, and what it does is it stitches one. I'll pick up the right stitch, Robin. It's stitch number 1 on this machine. Apologies, not number 5, number 1. So it stitches to the right, and it's going to just come over one stitch zigzag to the left. 5 stitches to the right, 1 stitch to the left. If you think you want your stitches, your zigzag closer, just wind this on up. So beg your pardon, on this machine it's stitch number 1. And then once you've got it set, if it's too wide you can bring this in, because you only want it just to catch this fabric. So it's stitching a zigzag to the left. If you don't have it wide enough, you won't catch your fabric. So you adjust your zigzag, leave everything else the same. So stitch number 1. They both look exactly the same, the stitches, but they go different ways. So on this machine, it's stitch number 1. When you get to the end, you can just overlap it. Needle up, take your work out. And remember, you've got a cutter at the back. Now, I should use a brighter colour, shouldn't I? One moment, please. I'm going to use a black, so that will show up, and it's a really thick thread. So I just want you to really, really see the stitch. It's not showing up enough on that. So I'm just going to see if this thick thread will stitch that just so you can see it. You wouldn't normally use a thick thread, but I just want you to see what the stitch is doing. Now remember, when you have it here, you can see the white of the foot, so you can thread your needle nice and easily. That will be a better thread for you to see. Got to think about that when I'm doing this. So let's do that again. We're on stitch number 1, 1 to 20, forward, right needle position, and I've got it on stitch length 2. And I'm using a thick thread now, just so you can see it. So it's stitching to the right, and it's jumping to the left. It's too thick. That thread, see how, now this is good. See how this is jammed? That thread is too thick to use. I don't have the correct needle. It's not happy. What do? You lift this up. You take your bobbin case out, because you don't want to have anything hindering it. Lift your foot up and very gently turn the balance wheel. And you see you've got your threads here. Don't yank them. Just clip the top one to release the tension, and then you can pull your thread out. There we are. So that thread is just too thick. So don't go pulling anything or pushing anything. Just unthread that. I'm going to take that out and use, I'll use this, would this red thread show up? Right, so let's see. So just go like this, very gently, and pull that out. So that's actually a blessing, because now you can see what to do if you get a jam up. Don't just yank things out. You don't want to damage anything. You've taken your shuttle out. Now, because you've taken your shuttle out, I want you to take it out completely and put it back in. So pop it in here. You've got your thread coming over the top, into there, come around, and there's a little cutout. And then keep coming and give it a tug and pull it, and it's going nice and freely. This opens up if you want. It goes in under here, and it goes from back to front, and you just feel it, and there's the click. So I'm going to try this thread. Is that going to show up? I think that's better. So let's try that again. So there. So that was interesting. So no, you do not want to use that thick thread. It was too thick. It was a 12 weight, just too heavy. So make sure you thread your needle front to back. If your needle holder is not showing at the front, you've put it in the wrong way. One rotation towards you will bring your bobbin thread up. If your bobbin thread doesn't pop up, then you haven't done it right. And I need to get it round my foot. There is my thread, and pull it back. Okay, now this foot I pull backwards and around because it has a little guide. Just going to take it off and show you. It has a little guide that goes all the way through the foot. So if I try to pull my thread left and right, it's just going to not go anywhere. So I pull it round behind that little guide. So put it on and then go in and go round behind it so the threads are always one side. Now let's just re-stitch that again, just so hopefully this time you'll see it. So here, and it's stitching on the right, and now it's going to go to the left. I think that you'll see that better. This one's going to be double stitched. Be much clearer when we get to this end. Just about need a fluoro thread. Right, now if I hold that there, can you just see this? Oh, come down here. The zigzag of the thread is just taking one bite out of the fabric. So it's stitching to the left and it's jumping over and taking a bite. Okay, now what happens when you turn it to the right side, I'll just take those pins out, is you cannot see where you've stitched it because it is blind hemmed. It is absolutely brilliant. And the skirt I'm wearing here is exactly how I've done my hem. You cannot see any of my stitches because I blind hemmed it. All right? So blind hemming on the back just looks like a straight stitch and one zigzag, a straight stitch and one zigzag. But when you turn it over, because that's now got two rows, you see nothing. So it's a beautiful way of hemming. And that is the blind hem stitch foot. I love it. And it stretches as well. So nothing will pop. It's really good. Now you can then choose to trim back this. Like that. And if you're lucky enough to have a pair of duckbill scissors, like I have got, out of my beautiful Bernina special edition scissors, I've got a pair of duckbill scissors, and this is what I use them for. You lay your fabric down flat, and this duckbill here lays against your fabric, and you simply trim back your fabric without cutting the underneath fabric. And they are brilliant. I use them also for cutting lace. So you get a much nicer, closer cut without cutting your underneath fabric. So it's very, very tidy. So those are called duckbill scissors and they're very, very good. Beautiful, beautiful scissors. So that is blind hemming. It's brilliant. Now the other foot I want to show you today, so I'm going to take that one off. I'll leave this thread on so you can see, is the gathering foot. So this is the gathering foot 179 on the old machines. It's got a single hole. So that means I need to go down to straight sewing, bring this back to zero. I need to go zero and center needle position. And I can have this on a long length because I want it to gather. So I put my foot on. I've got a single hole here. I hold my bobbin thread, I turn my balance wheel one rotation, and watch, I grab my bobbin thread and I slide it underneath. And that pulls my thread. I'm going to show you that again. I do one rotation towards you always, and then get your thread, and then just slide it underneath. And what it does is it pulls your top thread through that little hole. Now, if I put my fabric underneath here, run it on the edge, watch what happens. I'm just going to put my finger here so the fabric doesn't disappear out there. And it will just gather my fabric up by itself. Brilliant foot. Absolutely brilliant foot. Where's my thread? Okay, what have I done there? So again, I've no idea what I'm doing because it is jamming for no reason. I don't know. Maybe I didn't have enough thread out. Anyway, that was an easy one. That wasn't too bad. Don't know what I did. But look how that gathers up. See, and you can move it along. So this is a gathering foot, but watch what you can do. The fabric I want to gather, bring up your bobbin thread. There we go. So the fabric I want to gather goes underneath and the right side is facing up. I want to put it onto a piece of fabric. So this will go right side down in the middle of the foot. It's got a slit. Can you see that? So that's going in the middle of the foot. So I'm going to put that fabric there. I've got my foot down. And watch what happens. The underneath one will gather. Can you see? I'll try and lift it up so you can see. The underneath fabric is gathering while the top one is staying still. So you just keep these edges lined up. Isn't that brilliant? And the foot's doing all the work. You're just guiding it. So clever. Lift the foot up. Now have a look what we've done. Isn't that brilliant? So this foot can gather by itself or it can gather straight onto a fabric. Now, if I put the stitch length up, closer, I'm going to get a slightly different finish. So I'm just going to stitch just the foot. Oops, my threads. I'm just going to stitch, do the gather. So I put the stitch length a little bit closer. And look, it's really, really, really close together, the stitches. So normally that's not going to gather, is it? So you come out nice and long. And I hold my finger at the back. And you get a much better gather. So do not put your stitch length close. That didn't do anything. The longer the stitch length, the nicer the gather. So I just thought I'd like to show you those feet because I know a lot of people have got these feet in their machine boxes and they're not using them. So when I come back, my next video, I'll do two more sewing feet. But I just thought I'll just run through a couple a week and it'll get you using your sewing feet. So I'm very glad that the machine jammed up so you can see how to unjam it. And I'm really, really pleased that you're going to get these feet out of your boxes and you're going to start using them. Now, if you do like my videos, if you want to like and subscribe to my channel, then you'll get a reminder when my videos come out. So it's Robin Curd, C-U-R-D. And I hope you enjoyed the video.